Good morning, everybody. My name's Deborah Cane. I work in the Conservation Department. Some of you may recognise me from some of the Staffordshire Hoard blogs, but this year, one of my main roles is to work with the HLF Heritage Lottery Fund funded ICON Intern, and ICON stands for Institute for Conservation. We have Rose, who's our intern, and she's a qualified conservator, and she'll be working with us for a year to kind of learn on the job.
Hi, I'm Rose. I'm the new ICON intern at Birmingham Museum. One of my roles is to check the Hanwell system of the museum and the various sites. Hanwell records relative humidity and temperature as well as light.
Okay, and Rose, is that one of the loggers that we can see behind you by the computer? They're around in the galleries.
Yes, they're basically set within the exhibition spaces.
Okay. And the data comes back to this computer for you to check. Should we open up one of the charts? People can see what we're looking at.
So yeah, basically what you can see on this chart, hopefully, is the blue line, which is relative humidity, and the red line, which is temperature. As you can see, this has got quite a lot of fluctuation here, and relative humidity is most of the time sort of below the range we would like it to be, which would be between 40% and 65%.
Okay, and I think I've picked up on there on the chart that we're getting down to about 30%.
Yeah.
And when we say relative humidity, we mean
moisture which is trapped within the air. As a comparison, this is a recording within a case. As you can see, the temperature and relative humidity is very stable, and that's sort of what we ideally would like to have in all the galleries.
So we can see there that the relative humidity is about 45%. So the showcases are really helping to stabilise the environment for the objects.
Yeah.
So Rose, we've looked at the charts, but presumably you must also have to look at the galleries and understand them so that you understand if the data that you're seeing is correct for the objects that are displayed there.
Yes, you kind of have to know the layout of the heating systems, as well as where humidifiers are stored in which galleries, because obviously all that will affect the charts I see here. And we will be going up to the history galleries now to check some of the data, because we have seen some unusual movements. We came up to check one of the loggers, which you can see in the display case here. Because it tells us that within the case we have about 400 UV, which potentially, is too high, because it will UV radiation damages the textiles, for example. And we can see from this that if holding the device close to the one in the display case, that UV is zero around here. So we're expecting that the device which is in the display case is not set properly. It just says zero UV.
Okay, so Rose and I have checked the light levels in the gallery. There's no UV. We've checked the light levels in the case. There's no UV. We've checked the light levels by the window, which has the blind kept down. There's no UV. We've got a problem with the calibration of the logger, so we'll take that back to the office, sort it out, and get it back in the showcase so we can get the correct data for our monitoring.